Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at how to name chiral compounds. It's going to be largely the same as what you've already learned, but we'll add a locant and an absolute configuration for every chiral atom in the molecule. So if we look at our example here, we'd start numbering to give the substituent the lowest number. So I have a four-carbon chain, so that's going to be butane. It's going to be a 2-bromobutane, but that carbon with the bromine on it is chiral, so I need to assign an absolute configuration. So looking at my absolute configuration, the highest atomic number would be bromine, so that would be my number one substituent. On the right and the left-hand side of the carbon chain, I have a carbon on either side, and so that's a tie break, but then I look at what's attached to those carbons, and carbon three has on it another carbon. So going towards carbon three would be the second priority, and then carbon one would be the third priority, and my lowest priority group, four, would be pointing backwards. If I went in order of one, two, three, I'd see that I'm going clockwise, so that's going to be an R absolute configuration. So when I go to name this molecule, out in front of everything, in parentheses, is going to go both the locant, which would be 2 because it's on the second carbon, and the absolute configuration, R. So the 2R tells me I have one chiral carbon located at the second carbon, and the absolute configuration is R. And then I would just name like normal. So I still have to say 2-bromo, so they know what's on that carbon, that's the second one, and then my main chain would be butane. So I would just scoot that right up against the word butane. So in this example, we have more than one chiral carbon. We're gonna have to assign an absolute configuration to each of those, and then we'll put those absolute configurations out in front again with their locants in numerical order. So the highest priority group on the left-hand chiral carbon would be the chlorine, followed by the internal carbon, the external carbon, and then your hydrogen. So if I went from 1 to 2 to 3 here, I'd be going clockwise. That absolute configuration is R. On the right-hand side carbon, the iodine is the highest priority group. The internal carbon is second, methyl is third, and the hydrogen is your lowest priority group. Going from 1 to 2 to 3 there, you're going counterclockwise. So the absolute configuration there would be S. So in terms of numbering the molecule overall, no matter what direction I number from, it's going to have a 2-4 substitution. So in that instance, I would do a tie break using alphabetical order. So because C comes before I in the alphabet, I would number from the left-hand side. So this would be carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I would have then a 2R 4S out in front. That tells me what chiral carbons I have, their absolute configurations, and their locations because of the 2 and the 4, the locants. So those are in numerical order. I'm still going to alphabetize in terms of where the substituents are. So 2-chloro, 4-iodo, pentane. So this has been a look at how to name chiral molecules. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.